Thank you for joining this Capella webinar. Stéphane, could, yes, thank you. I'm Samuel Rocher. I'm working for Robeo, and I will be your moderator today. I just want to inform that as we are not attending this webinar, your microphone is mute to avoid background noise. And after today's talk, we have a Q&A session. So if you have any question, please use the dedicated Q&A windows to ask your question during or after the talk. And also, this webinar is being recorded, and it will be available on the Capella YouTube channel as usually. So next slide, please, Stéphane. Thank you. So it's my pleasure to welcome and introduce today's speaker, Stéphane Lacrampe. Stéphane co-founded Robeo in 2005 and acted as the company CEO for 12 years. In 2018, he moved to Vancouver to foster the company business in North America and act now as the director of Robeo Canada. Focusing on Capella is strongly involved in the MBSC community. He is an active INCOSI member, acting as the co-chair of the System Engineering and Tool Database Working Group. He is an MBSC enthusiast presenting at national and international conferences and is a very active evangelist for the development of the Capella ecosystem. And without further ado, I'm going to hand over to Stéphane. So let me make your presenter, Stéphane.
Thank you, Samuel, and thank you to all the attendees who joined today's webinar. I'm going to talk about Team for Capella. So Team for Capella is a Capella add-on enabling live collaboration on models and representations. And as I work for Robeo, I would like to start by saying a few words about the company. So we are a tooling company, and as such, we are developing software for modeling. In other words, we are creating visual modeling technologies, most of them as open source, and we help our customers to build the right modeling tool for designing their complex systems or to overcome some of their business challenges. We operate worldwide in domains such as aerospace and defense, transportation, energy, healthcare, and services. We have three main offerings. The first one for MBSC is based on Capella. More to come on this on the next slide. Our second offer is Robeo Smart EA. It is an enterprise architecture software implementing the TOGAF and Archimate standards. And our third offer is Robeo Designer, a modeling solution enabling you to build your own graphical modeling environment. Robeo Designer is based on the Sirius open source framework. And actually, these three offers are relying on open source technologies for which we are contributing significantly. And our business model includes a large part of professional services, enabling our customers to leverage these modeling technologies. Quick focus on our Capella offering before diving into Team for Capella. So first, we offer training, coaching, and support on Arcadia and Capella through our partner Thales, who created Capella. I am convinced that these are key activities to get your teams on the right track for a successful deployment of MBSC with Capella. Second, we offer services for configuring, extending, or integrating Capella with other tools and environments. So by this, I mean that we can help you, for instance, to build Capella viewpoints for adding non-functional properties evaluation. Or another example is we can help you to use M2Doc for generating Word documents from Capella models. And finally, we sell the Team for Capella add-on, which is today's topic. Now, before taking a more in-depth look at Team for Capella, I would like to talk about why we are doing this webinar on this commercial add-on. It is related to the collaboration that we started a long time ago with Thales on Capella. As you probably know, Thales has created the Arcadia method and the Capella tool, and Robeo has been a key external partner in this journey. In this context, we have developed Sirius, the open source tool for building graphical modeling environment, Sirius being one of the core components of Capella. We have also developed Team for Capella for Thales, and both organizations are active in developing the Capella adoption since 2014, when it became open source. So I believe it is fair to say that OBEO has a central role in the animation of the Capella community. And for instance, we are organizing the regular Capella webinars like this one today. We are also organizing the annual Capella Days conference, and we are representing Capella at many systems engineering conferences worldwide. So when Capella became open source, Thales and OBEO decided to set up a commercial offer providing what is required for large-scale adoption of the tool. This includes providing training, coaching, ready-to-use add-ons, and professional services for Capella. And Team for Capella is part of this offer. So I do believe that Team for Capella add-on is an awesome piece of technology and that it really enables efficient team collaboration when modeling with Capella. But my point here is that the revenue we get from Team for Capella also contributes to sustaining all these activities that we do and also to make Capella better. So that's something I wanted to share with you as well. And of course, we are also welcoming all sorts of contributions. And for instance, we see more and more sponsoring initiatives from various organizations for developing new Capella features, which is great. So thank you all for your support, and I hope you'll enjoy this webinar today. So now let's move to the main topic of today's webinar, Team for Capella. First, let me elaborate on why Team for Capella is a key Capella add-on. So Capella is using files to store models. This is okay if you're working alone on your project, but this may become problematic if you have more people collaborating on the same file. Indeed, merging models' differences can quickly become a complex, error-prone, and time-consuming task. So to mitigate this, users can break down their models into separate files called fragments. But even in this case, as your team or model grows in size, you will face the same type of issue due to the nature of models. They are graphs containing highly interconnected elements. So in practice, this situation can decrease your team efficiency. So in short, Team for Capella enables efficient usage of Capella when working in teams. The solution we propose with Team for Capella is to store models in a shared repository, enabling users to simultaneously edit their models. The user experience is similar to the one you get with concurrent editing in Google Docs or Google Sheets. I mean, everyone works directly on the same model or diagram at the same time, and Team for Capella manages automatically concurrent accesses to the data at the finest possible grain. This is a core feature brought by Team for Capella. So let me show you a demo of this. So in this video, you will follow on the same screen the workbench of two Capella users who are remotely connected to Team for Capella. You have Bob on the left and Kim on the right, and as soon as Bob starts editing a label on a function, he takes the lock on this element shown as a green lock, and Kim is automatically notified as a red lock appears on her diagram, meaning that she won't be able to modify this element. Bob also modified the layout on the diagram, so it is also locked for Kim or any other user. Kim can still modify other elements on the diagram as she does, Bob is automatically notified with a red lock. As soon as the user hits the save button, his changes are committed to the repository and the corresponding logs are released. Kim realizes that her diagram is now out of sync, so she needs to refresh it. And finally, when she saves her changes, the logs are released on Bob's side and he can now see the changes made by Kim. Another way of working with Team for Capella is by using explicit locking. So Bob is locking all the functions and subfunctions under play video stream on cabin screen. He can modify the functions with a green lock, and he can also create new functions and diagrams. So you see that these new elements are not locked as they are not existing on the Team for Capella repository yet. Explicit locking is useful when a user wants to prevent other users from making any change on a part of a model. When it does save, Kim still can't modify the explicitly locked element, but she can see and may modify the new elements created by Bob after refreshing her diagram. Then, if Bob starts to modify those new elements again, he will take the lock on them. And as they now exist in the repository, Kib is now getting a red lock as well on this new element. And Bob is still doing a few modifications. So meanwhile, Kim can concentrate on other parts of the model. She's now opening another diagram, but she's modifying a function that is also represented on Bob's diagram. So Bob gets a red lock on this element. What I want you to realize here is that all the red locks you see on one diagram actually mean that the underlying semantic elements are locked for modification. Any diagram, property view, table containing this semantic element will display a red lock. So now going back to the demo, as Kim and Bob save their changes, all the temporary locks are released and the changes are made available to the other users. And finally, when Bob is done working, he manually releases all the elements that he had explicitly locked previously so that any other user may work on them. So the main, So the main benefit of Team for Capella is, of course, that it enables to have several users to work on the same model or diagrams, all in parallel, and you won't have to manage conflicts on or to spend time doing diff and merge of models. It really improves your team efficiency, and using Team for Capella is quite easy and intuitive, as the locking and unlocking mechanism is transparent and automatic. But I would like to stress another important change brought by Team for Capella. All Capella users now have a centralized place where they can easily access the last and up-to-date version of their models and start to work on them right away. Now I would like to go through some of the other features that you'll find in Team for Capella. The first one is about importing and exporting Capella projects. Exporting means that you're uploading one of your local Capella projects to share it with others. Once you've shared a project, other users can connect to it and collaborate. Importing is doing the opposite of exporting, so basically downloading a Team for Capella shared project into a local copy. Let me show you this in a short demo. Here we are using the in-flight entertainment system model example, and the local project is already created and we are going to export it to the Team for Capella server. So we right click on the project and we select export, and then we select export model to remote repository. And before triggering the export, we are required to test that we can connect to the Team for Capella repository. So for this, you enter the login and password, and then we hit the next button. And here we're going to select an option that will automatically connect us to the shared project just after the export is finished. By doing so, the user can start to work on the shared project right away. Finally, we click on finish and we wait for the export to proceed. So this will just take a few seconds. So now we are getting a pop-up indicating that the process went well. And we also have a new wizard that popped up offering to connect to the project we've just uploaded on the Team for Capella server. From now on, other users may also connect and start working on this shared project using a very similar connection wizard. You see, now we have two projects in the workspace, the initial local one we exported and the one we've just uploaded on Team for Capella, which is connected to Team for Capella. So you can see that we are connected as user one on this project and we may start modifying this project. OK, Okay, going back to the slide. So what all this means for you as well is that you are not locked in with when using Teams for Capella. At any moment in time, you can import your projects locally and work on them with the usual Capella open source version. So now on the next slide, I'm going to talk about version control. And I think my goal here is to make sure that everybody understands Teams for Capella is not a version control system. A version control system is used for model versioning, clearly identifying baselines and managing branches. Teams for Capella manages the concurrent access and modification of Capella models in a live manner, enabling seamless day-to-day collaboration. So in other words, Teams for Capella is used in conjunction with a version control system. So let me illustrate this. Let's say you have on the left of the slide the versioning system your organization is using. It could be SVN, Git, or a PLM like Teamcenter, for instance. And at some point in time, your team wants to work and collaborate on a version of your Capella project. So one user is going to check out the model from the version control system. And as we saw on the previous demo, he's going to upload it on the Teams for Capella repository. From there, users can access simultaneously and make changes to the model. Then, after a while, you may want to version your model. So one user is going to download the project from Teams for Capella and store it in your version control system. Users can still work and collaborate on the model. And depending on your internal policy, you may repeat this versioning process automatically at a given frequency, like every day, for instance. And you may execute it manually as well after a week of work, for example, because you're finished with your current sprint and you want to set a version tag on it. So at this point, you're going to check your model back in your versioning system, and you may delete your Teams for Capella repository as your collaboration session is finished. And then when your collaboration session starts again, you can repeat the same process. Pushing the logic a little bit further, you may have several versions of your model in your versioning system, and these versions are still evolving. So you will have several Teams for Capella repositories in parallel, like one for collaborating on maintaining version 1, one for version 2, and one for the master version. And those Teams for Capella shared repositories are not permanent. They live as long as collaboration sessions are necessary on one given version of a model, and the repository can be deleted once the collaboration session is finished. Now a focus on security. We'll see later in the presentation that you may use Teams for Capella on a cloud environment, but by default, Teams for Capella is installed on premises, meaning that all your data stays internally. So in terms of managing user access to the Teams for Capella server, we support LDAP authentication. We support SSL encryption between the Capella client and the server. And we also have a mechanism for managing modification rights on the model through user profiles, as shown in the next slide. So here you see two screenshots. The first one on the left is showing how you can configure access rights using user profiles. Combining these features with model fragmentation will enable you to define modification rights for subparts of your model. In this example, we have defined one model fragment per engineering layer, so we can now define who has modification rights for the operational analysis, system analysis, logical architecture, and physical architecture. The other screenshot on the right is displaying how your model looks like if you do not have the right to modify some model elements. You will see gray locks. Now let's move to another interesting feature, the commit history view. Teams for Capella records all the changes made on a model, who made them, when, and you may also add a description for each model modification you saved. The commit history view enables you to visualize this information. Let's see a demo of this. So the committees to review is the window located at the bottom center and right of the workbench. You can see a list of the last commits made in the Team for Capella repository for the current diagram. By commit, we simply mean that you did a modification on your model and you saved them in the Team for Capella repository. So in this list, when you select a single commit, you can see a textual description at the bottom of the view, and you can also see which model elements were created, modified, or deleted on the right. If several commits are selected, the semantic elements shown on the right are all the ones related to the selection. In other words, it aggregates the information from all the selected commits. It is also possible for a given commit to display the impacted representation, meaning the graphical changes related to a commit. So you can select each commit and you'll see on the right of the window which diagrams or tables have been modified by this commit. Another way of using this view is to display commit associated with the current selection in your diagram. This information can be refreshed automatically for each selection you make, or you can activate a manual refresh. Going back to the previous mode, we see now all the commits related to the current diagram. We see that we have two commits that have the same description and the same author, as this may happen sometimes when doing consecutive modification and saves. Here, we can activate an option that graphically merges them in one single commit to make the list easier to read. And finally, you can use a filter box to perform a text search on commit description. This is useful when, after a while, you end up having a lot of commits, for instance. Here we are looking for all commit descriptions that contains the word rename. So that's it for this demo. Let's go back to the slide. So Team for Capella also comes with a set of administration tools. You can access most of them from a web browser, and among other things, it will enable you to configure the server to start and to stop it, or to automate some tasks like scheduling automatic backups of your repository, or automatic check-ins of your model into your version control system. So just a quick look at the scheduler, as it is the main interface for administration tools. We are in the process of reorganizing all the jobs for the next Team for Capella version. All jobs will be grouped by theme. So we'll have backup and restore jobs, diagnostic and repair jobs, server management jobs, and templates jobs that you can customize. Now let's see how you can deploy Team for Capella. We have two different ways that I'm going to detail in the next two slides. Either on-premises deployment, meaning that you deploy Team for Capella on your own IT systems, or cloud-based deployment. So on-premise deployment option first. Well, first of all, the Team for Capella software is made of two parts, the add-on part installed on the Capella client, and the server-side part, hosting the repository and the administration tools. When deploying Team for Capella on-premises, there are mainly two options to do it, and you can actually mix both of them. So either the users have Capella with Team for Capella done installed on their local machine, and they will connect remotely to the Team for Capella server, or in case of high connection latency, for instance, the Team for Capella clients may be installed in a virtual machine on the server side, and the users will access their Capella client through a remote desktop protocol. So in other words, if your teams are geographically distributed, or if you want to collaborate with external partners, the second option, using virtual machines, is probably the right solution. For cloud-based deployment, it is very similar to the second option I just described, except that the server is not hosted on your IT systems, but on a public cloud like AWS. So in this case, all users are accessing their Team for Capella clients using a remote desktop protocol. One of the advantages of this option is that Obeo is taking care of all the installation of the Team4 Capella servers and clients, and it is also useful if your users are using different operating systems like Windows, Mac, Linux, and you want you may want also having external partners to access your models without installing having to install anything. Now a different but important topic, how Team4 Capella integrates with other add-ons. Not going too much into technical details there are a few technical aspects that one has to pay attention when building Capella add-ons so that they work in a Team4 Capella environment. Having said that, most of the open source add-ons listed on the Capella website are compatible with Team4 Capella. For commercial add-ons, we may establish partnership with other tool vendors to ensure that they are working well together. But in any case, whether you're a tool provider or if you are building your own Capella viewpoints and extensions, we will be happy to provide you the required expertise to ensure a good integration of your add-ons in a Team4 Capella environment. The last topic for today is about the roadmap. So Team4 Capella milestones are aligned with the Capella ones. There are technical reasons for this. For instance, Team4 Capella needs to take into account the Capella metamodel evolution. So this means that we have one main version per year and at least one main maintenance version per year. The last version we released is Team4 Capella 1.3.2. In March 2020, and it is aligned with Capella version 1.3.2. Team4 Capella 1.4.1 is the next maintenance version, and it's planned for July 2020. So it's 1 month later than the usual schedule due to the COVID-19 situation. In this version, you'll find a completely reorganized documentation so that each user can find easily the appropriate information he needs depending on his role. We have also worked on improving the compatibility with add-ons like the property value management tool. So for those who don't know this add-on that we call sometimes PVMT, I do recommend it. It is very useful for extending the Capella data model. So back to Team4 Capella 1.4.1, you'll find also evolution on the administration side. We saw one of them earlier in the presentation when I displayed the scheduler having new and reorganized administration jobs. We also made a set of fixes and improvements in the tool as we always do for maintenance version. And it's part of our effort to continuously improve the product. So another example of continuous improvement is the work that we are doing on time and memory consumption. These diagrams show measures between Team4 Capella 1.2 and 1.3, where we significantly reduced project opening duration. Other figures I have is a 25 to 60% time decrease for diagram refresh for Team4 Capella 1.3.1. And up to 60% time improvement on project opening for version 1.4.0. In the next release, we have reduced by 60% the duration for closing projects when they have open diagrams. So given the current COVID situation, we checked with most of our customers to see how Team4 Capella was behaving while working remotely from home. And we got very positive feedback on this. So I would like to take this opportunity today to thank the development team for all the hard work and these great results. And then the next major version is due for December 2020. It will be Team4 Capella 5.0. So that we keep the numbering aligned with Capella. Indeed, the Capella team decided to change their version numbering policy so that it is better aligned with the current Eclipse development guidelines. So the next Capella version will also be a 5.0. In this version, we will add WebSocket support as a new communication protocol between the clients and the server. So this means that deploying Team4 Capella will not require anymore to open ports as it will go through HTTPS instead. Version 5.0 will also include an Eclipse and Java upgrade aligned with the Capella ones. I believe that the Java version should move from 1.8 today to version 11 or 13, still to be confirmed. And we will also add Linux support for the server for Team for Capella. There will be other things added for this major release as the roadmap is building up. And please do not hesitate to send us your needs as we want to build a better product. I have got one last demo to show you as we plan to add support for disconnected mode as well. This means that you'll be able to work on a local version of your project, modify it while you're disconnected, and then reconcile those changes with the shared project once you connect again to Team for Capella. So what you see on the left are two identical Capella projects, one local and one on the server. And I selected and compared both models, and the main window is showing the result, which is there is no difference. What I'm going to do now is to modify the local project. So I open an operational activity interaction diagram and start to modify the layout of the diagram, as well as adding an interaction between two activities. And finally, I can save my changes when I'm finished. So now I go on the shared project and open a data diagram to simulate somebody modifying the model on the server while I was working on my local one. Here, I'm going to modify a class and then copy and paste it to create a second one. And you'll see that we are getting the green lock as we are working with a connected Team for Capella project. So I'm going to save these changes when I'm finished. And then I go back to my diff merge window and refresh the model comparison. We have to wait a little bit that it processes. And then I can start to explore the changes that were detected. We see that we have some changes on the diagrams. We have the incoming change from the CDB diagram and also the operational analysis, but I did not extend this section. And then we also see that we have changes on the actual data model, just below there. I can start to send my local modification to the Team for Capella server, selecting both the corresponding diagrams and the data model elements. And then once I've done that, I can select apply change on the right and I can launch the merge operation. I can also do it on the other way and merge changes from the repository back to my local project. Right. And then finally, I'm going to save all those changes. So in short, supporting the disconnected mode means that you'll be able to work locally on your project and to synchronize those changes back to the server with the diff merge window. It is planned for Team for Capella 5.0, but we may have it ready for Team for Capella 1.1, so stay tuned on this. So to wrap up this presentation today, Team for Capella manages the concurrent access and modification of Capella models in a live manner, enabling easy and seamless day-to-day collaboration, and all team members can access and work concurrently on the same models and diagrams. It is a key component when deploying Capella on operational projects, having a team of system engineers using Capella and Arcadia. So please do not hesitate to contact us if you're interested in using Team for Capella. We provide evaluation versions that give you full access to the Team for Capella features for a limited period of time, and we will be happy to assist you in this evaluation. So with that, I would like to thank you all for your attention, and I'm open for questions.
Thank you, Stefan, for this presentation and for sharing some of your insights with us. Indeed, it's time to see if we have some questions. Yes, actually, we have some questions. Okay, so first one. Is there a way to do some explorative modeling without making it visible to you others and the option to commit or discard it at the latter time?
Sorry, I didn't get the end of the question and the option.
To commit or Discord you are partly morning.
Right. So you I guess there are a few different ways of doing this. You may, for instance, download the shared project locally and start to work on it to try things. You may also try things on the connected project and do what you just did if you don't want to commit things. I guess you may also work on the shared project, and if you don't want to commit your change, you may maybe disconnect, close it and reopen another one. So there may be different options for doing it. I wouldn't say there is a feature where you would say, okay, let's record all the changes I'm doing, and at the end I'll actually decide if I want to commit them or not.
When is a floating license claimed? For instance, you need to read only or to import something.
Yeah, so actually we support different type of licensing mode, which can be floating or named, but that's not the question, I guess. Well, the licenses are required as long as you're going to access to the Team Server repository. So whether you're in a read-only mode or editing mode does not make any difference. You will need a license. Importing data to the Team for Capella server is also requiring a license. What does not require a license is if somebody has downloaded the Team for Capella project on a local Capella client. Once it's downloaded as a local project, you don't need a license anymore to work on it.
Just a precision, you don't need a license for the import wizard and for the automatic backup. It's considered as a Team for Capella feature. Most people won't use a specific license for that.
Yes, I mean all the basically the administration tools does not require an additional license.
Okay, next question. Can you merge different branches from Git?
I guess this is not a Team for Capella question, because I mean you may want to merge Git branches without having Team for Capella, and you can even extend the question to any version control system. So the answer is yes, you can do a diff and merge of Capella projects from different branches. And obviously, depending on the number and the complexity of the changes you made, the diff and merge operation may be more complex. Merging diagrams as well can be a little bit tricky. But you can definitely do it, and we have a lot of users who do that.
Even that's all related to Team for Capella. But yes. Okay. How the tool integrates with Team Center and System Modeling Workbench?
Let me think a little bit about that. So yes, I mean Team for Capella works well with System Modeling Workbench and Team Center. We are planning to provide an enhanced integration, but right now it's working well. So you can use Team for Capella with System Modeling Workbench, and the Team Center environment is used as a version control system, kind of, if you remember the slide I showed about that.
Okay. This question isn't really one actually. This is more an invitation to participate to this project. So, well, we will consider it, but maybe we don't discuss it right now. And thanks to you for the invitation, by the way. And next question. Okay, you talked about Git SVN. Is there a way to work with another conflict management platform like IBM Jarvis platform?
I don't know all the version control system platforms or configuration platforms. It's actually not dependent on Team for Capella. The question comes down to can you store your Capella files and your Capella projects in JAS, for instance? So I assume that you can do that. It's basically storing files in a software configuration management tool. And if you can do that, then you can use also Team for Capella with JAS, basically.
Okay, before to ask the next question, I will just precise that this is the same people who invite us to a collaborative project. So is Team for Capella free?
No, no. So Team for Capella is not free. It's a commercial add-on that we sell. I believe that we have a reduction for R&D projects, but it's not a free and open source add-on. It's a commercial add-on.
Okay. Is it possible to restore the diagram to a null commitment?
Is it possible to restore a diagram to an old commit? Is that the
Yes.
question?
Yes.
I don't think so. Well, there are, I would say, two things. You may restore a previous version of your repository, either using your version control system or using the automatic backups. So automatic backups are regular backups that you can configure on the administration tools side of Team for Capella server. And for instance, you may generate a backup every hour or every half an hour. So you could revert your project to the state which it was half an hour ago, for instance, or an hour ago, depending on the frequency that you selected your backups to run. And then if you're the one who changed the diagram and you have kept your Capella session open, you may revert the diagram by doing undo a few times, but that's maybe a side way of doing it. So basically, using the restoring backups would be the way to do it. But
Okay.
that's an interesting suggestion actually, that could be a feature of Team for Capella, I guess.
Okay, thanks, Stefan. And I think actually we have a lot of questions regarding the integration with Teamcenter, with Siemens Teamcenter and the BU, that we already have answered this one. So I think we have answered all the questions now.
Okay.
So last chance for the attendee to ask last question. Okay, if it occurs, we'll try to answer. Can we go to the next slide to conclude?
Yeah.
And yes, thanks again, Stefan, for those presentation and your answers. Okay, as you can see, this is our upcoming schedule. We will have a very interesting webinar program for the forthcoming month with three operational use cases from telecommunication, energy, and space domain. So save the date, May 27, June 9, and June 25. So finally, when you will be leaving this webinar, we will be grateful if you can give us some feedback about today by filling out the satisfaction form. And please do not hesitate to contact us if you have any questions. Thanks again and goodbye.